Now on Firepower TV, the gun guys make it their mission to go after Sig Arms' claim of to hell and back reliability with a gauntlet of extreme torture tests for one tough combat handgun. We'll drop it, drag it, drench it, and try to destroy it. Will it survive the mayhem? But that's not all. We'll tear through a whole lineup of Sig hardware with a crazy level of commando cruelty that makes Firepower TV downright explosive entertainment. So take cover and man your battle stations. The gun guys are coming at you right now.
Traded them in, got newer SIGs. When they go through this gun, they replace any worn parts or parts that could be worn. And what they do is they bring out a gun that is just like new, but I mean, this, it has a warranty.
This gun looks brand new right here.
Yeah, that's a 239 right there. And you know, they make it 9mm 357 SIG and 40. And the barrel's interchanged between the 357 SIG and the 40. It's a single stack, it's a compact gun, easy to carry.
And these are duty tested.
Yeah, every one of these have come from the police department. That's why they call it duty tested.
Now, tell me a little bit about what we've got through here. Take us through the lineup of SIGs we got.
Well, the first gun here on the end is a SIG P220. They've been making this for a long time. For the guy that likes a 1911, but he would like to have it in double action, this gun is perfect. It's got the Nitron finish on it. It's an excellent gun. They say straight out of the box is one of the most accurate 45s you'll get.
You think I get Nitron finish on top of my head?
You might, but I don't think it'll help much.
Oh, thanks.
But they do. They offer that in a 7 and 8 round mags. Then this is one of the most popular. This is the P226, and they offer it in 9mm, 357 SIG, and 40 also. Pretty much your standard platform, but this is a full-size gun. It's double-stack mag. You can always get your pre-band high-cap mags, or they come now with standard 10-rounders.
Now, this is very similar to what the SEALs use, right?
Yes, the Navy SEALs are using one very similar, basically, and that's something we'll look at here in just a few more minutes in the show, and you'll see it's basically the same gun.
Okay, what else we got?
You go down to the 229 now, which is a little smaller gun, okay, and you get just a hair under a 4-inch barrel. So for concealment, this gun's a little bit better than your full size. We just looked at in the 226. Again, 9mm, 40, 357 SIG, and then 357 SIG gives you pretty much revolver capabilities and that famous 357 Magnum, but you get to put it in a semi-auto.
It looks like a little mini assault rifle cartridge.
Yeah, it's almost a neck down, bottleneck 40 is what it is, and it's got a 9mm bullet basically, and it's just an excellent round. It's got a lot of velocity, a lot of knockdown power.
A 229 kind of gives you the best of both worlds as far
as
size.
Yes, it does, and it has a stainless slide also.
Okay, tell me about this right here. This is one that's a little bit different. You don't see very often.
Yeah, that's a little gun. They've made that for a while, and it's, you know, been real popular over the years and around the world. It's a P225, and it's 9mm in its single stack. For people who have small hands, women, you know, just for guys or women that have really tiny hands that can't get a hold of the double stack mags, much better, more comfortable
to
shoot.
As compared to your big go-go gadget.
Yeah, exactly. That doesn't feel so good in my hands where the 226 does or 229 does.
And we talked about the 239. I tell you what, let's do this. Let's go down and put these through a range test.
Okay.
Now they say these are certified pre-owned, but they haven't been Firepower TV certified. We've got some torture tests lined up. We're going to do that as well. Let's get on it.
Let's go.
Okay, we're here at the Firepower TV range. We've got some certified pre-owned SIG pistols. They're just like new. I've got the 226 and 357 SIG. Wes has the 229 and 40. We're gonna go for the metal poppers. You ready there, Urban Assault Barney?
Yeah.
Let's go. Not bad. Let's go ahead and put another mag through. You got a second mag?
Yeah.
Let's do one more mag. Very nice. I've got the 228 9mm. Wes has the 226 at 9mm. We're going for the steel poppers again. You ready there, big boy?
Yep.
Nice. Got some more certified pre-owned SIG pistols. I've got the 239 and 357 SIG. Wes has the ever popular 225 in a 9mm. More metal bad guys going down. You ready, big boy?
Yep.
Let's go. Perfect. This is the 220 and 45. We're gonna take on some metal bad guys. Here we go.
It's time to test the certified pre-owned SIG 226 Firepower TV style. We started by getting out our chopper and taking to the air. Once I could see the bright white X on the pavement, and after our pilot gave me the thumbs up that we were holding at 170 feet, I began tossing the 226s right out the side. It was hard for me to see what was happening to the guns when they hit, but from the reaction of the team on the ground, it must have been a sight to see, especially when I dropped the 226 that was frozen in the block of ice for more than a week. All I could see was the ice explode from the impact. We put the chopper down so I could take a closer look, thinking we may be calling the party off early if none of the SIGs made it. Each had earned a few battle scars from the drop, but were all fully operational. Drop test passed. But I'm not done yet. More to come on that later.
Don't go away. You won't believe what Chip and Wes destroy on the Firepower TV range next. Firepower TV with the Gun Guys is brought to you by SIG Arms Precision Made Firearms and by the FirepowerTV.us World Web Store, your destination for firearms, ammunition, and accessories.
In 1821, Stephen F. Austin contracted to bring 300 families west. He formed a group of Rangers for the common defense. Today, Austin's Texas Rangers are North America's oldest statewide law enforcement agency, and you still don't mess with Texas. One riot, one Ranger. That's their can-do attitude. Only one gun fits their bill. The Sig Sauer P226. One riot, one Ranger, one gun. Sig Sauer. Hell and back reliability for when it counts.
FirepowerTV.us is the premier target destination on the web for shooting enthusiasts. FirepowerTV.us has the latest and greatest info on the gun guys and the Firepower TV show, as well as great deals on gear and ammo at the Firepower World Web Store. Set your sights on FirepowerTV.us for great deals and join the heavy metal Firepower movement.
Best prices, best selection. That's what you'll find at John Jones GM City when you're ready to buy that new GM vehicle. We have the best selection at the lowest prices. Come see why so many people cross the bridge for great deals at our three Southern Indiana locations. We will not be undersold. With four makes to choose from, choose a vehicle to fit your life and your budget. 2004 Chevrolet Cavaliers from $10,229. You see so many because they paid so little. John Jones GM City. Call 1-800-ISELL-GM.
Grab your helmet and hide under a table. Wes and Chip are about to rock and roll on the Firepower TV range.
Welcome back to Firepower TV with the Gun Guys. Chip and Wes hanging with you. And I tell you what, Wes, I got to roll out Captain Excitement for what we got on this table. Now, we've got some very special SIG 226s. What are they?
Well, this is actually the SIG 226 Navy SEAL gun. This is what they are currently using as their sidearm. Now, what will be fooling to you is when you look at it right away, it's going to look like a standard 226, but it isn't. It has a little boat anchor on the outside, and that's how you're going to be able to tell the difference between the Navy SEAL. Also, the Navy SEAL model is going to have a specially serialized number that starts with NSW and then the following number.
Now, one great thing that SIG is doing is they're giving $50 from every gun purchase of these to the Special Operations Warrior Foundation.
Yes, for the fallen heroes, the money's going to go to their children. And what's going to happen with that is SIG's already donated $50,000 and they've committed up to $100,000.
That's amazing. I tell you what, so not only do I get the exact gun the SEALs are using,
I'm helping out a great cause in the meantime.
Exactly, at the same time.
Now, I tell you what, I have been very excited about this, and I have been rubbing it, and I have been petting it. And I'm going to tell you what, this is a Chip Commando Crew version of the SIG 552 Commando and 223. Tell us a little bit about this.
Well, it's a very compact, small barrel, a little under 9-inch barrel, 223, gas operated. It has a collapsing stock there, will fold all the way around when the mags aren't connected there. That's another feature that's really nice about this gun is you can stack your mags together, so you don't have to go to a mag pouch like on your vest here and try to pull a mag out. You pull your mag out, quick chain shoot, pull your mag, and it's a very quick system. It's got your different rear aperture sight. You have night sights on the back, has a front night sight on the front post. The way we have this one set up here is it's got a quad rail on it. Now, they don't always come with this. This is an option. You also have your optic rail up here if you don't have a quad rail to put your optics on.
Now, the stock will also fold, too, when you don't have the mags in.
Exactly, and that makes it very, very compact and easy to keep on you.
I'm going to tell you what, this thing is absolutely one of the coolest machine guns I think I have ever seen.
Yeah, and it's got a huge gas tube, and one thing that it allows it to feed really well, one of the unique pieces about it is the barrel sits very, very low. You expect the barrel to be up here. It's not. It's down here. So when you're shooting it, you don't have a lot of felt recoil raising up. It's straight back.
I'm going to shoot it.
well, you'll find out.
I'm going to really blow some stuff up.
We'll find out, see what you think.
I tell you what, we've got single shot, three round burst, and full auto.
Full auto, right? Correct. So anything you would ever need for any tactical situation.
Well, I tell you what, let's get down there and let's shoot these, and then let's resume our Firepower TV torture test on our certified pre-owned 6R pistol.
Let's do it.
Let's go for it! Okay, take a look at this. This is the 226 Navy. It's just like what the Navy SEALs get. Now a civilian could buy one of these. It's a limited edition. Watch what we're gonna do down here to the shooting gallery. You ready?
Yep.
Peace through superior firepower. That is my motto. Finally, a weapon worthy of me. This is the 552 Commando 223. I'm working an EOTech on the quad rail. Okay, more with the 552 Commando from SIG. Look at this, the mags actually attach together. They're made that way for quick reloads. Three shot burst to start. Oh! One excellent thing about the SIG 552 Commando is the folding stock. I've added the Surefire 4 grip. I'm gonna go for the lighthouse I stole from the putt-putt part. Full auto. Did I hit the lighthouse? Full auto. All right, I'm gonna use the SIG 552 Commando to repaint the lighthouse. I believe
that's watermelon. I do works of art. I am a painter. Ah! A masterpiece.
After the SIGs made it past my drop test, it was time to bring out the heavy equipment. We grabbed our U.S. Army 6x6 5-ton truck. I put the SIGs down the pavement in its path, but instead of just running them over, I decided to have the driver park on top of the pistol with the full weight of the vehicle's engine, pushing them into the pavement. I thought this would surely crack the frames, but after several minutes, the driver pulled forward to reveal the firearms completely intact. The decockers weren't even bit. But there's no rest for the weary when you're in combat. So I administered the old drug by the horse test. We pulled out the steel cable and attached the carabiner to the trigger guards on two of our 226s. We drug the SIGs over pavement at high speeds for over a half mile, even dragging them through gravel. When we arrived at our destination, I began my thorough field inspection. Both pistols were still working fine. Park and drag test passed.
So far, so good, boys.
But now I'm really hell-bent on pushing these guns to the edge of durability.
More heavy metal mayhem on the Firepower TV range when we return.
FirepowerTV.us is the premier target destination on the web for shooting enthusiasts. FirepowerTV.us has the latest and greatest info on the gun guys in the Firepower TV show, as well as great deals on gear and ammo at the Firepower World Web Store. Set your sights on FirepowerTV.us for great deals and join the heavy metal firepower movement.
Firepower TV with the Gun Guys is brought to you by SIGARMS Precision Made Firearms and by the FirepowerTV.us World Web Store, your destination for firearms, ammunition, and accessories. It's time to get back to the bald and the big, Shippin' West the Gun Guys.
Welcome back to Firepower TV. You know how the show works. We blow stuff up, you sit at home and you laugh at us. Now I tell you what, we've got some more cool stuff from SIG. Let's start with what's in front of you. They look just like 1911s, but they're special. Tell me about them.
Well, they are 1911s. SIG has put their own spin on the 1911 market. They've joined into the market. This is a stainless, this is also stainless frame and slide, but it has their nitron finish on it. It's 5-inch barrel, 1911. Standard 1911 parts are interchangeable. It's got a match grade barrel in it. It's got an oversized safety. It's got the memory beaver tail, high rise beaver tail. It's got a very nice trigger in it. It's hand fitted, very well made, and Novak sights. It's got a lot of features. Has external extractor, so good feeding and extracting control. Just a great gun all overall. Plus, it fits the tactical applications because it's got their rail system on it.
I'm going to tell you what, this is just a bad looking gun.
It is, especially the black one. I like the stainless too, but that one's really good looking. And SIG kind of put their design slide with the 1911, not the standard 1911. Mm-hmm. So it still gives it a SIG look, even though it's a 1911.
Now if you look at the slide, one thing I notice is it's a little more squared off than a normal 1911.
Right, just like their
cool
226s, 220s, everything. That's what I said. They gave it their own little spin on it. So
kind of keeps that SIG feel to the squared slide.
Exactly.
That's cool. Now, I tell you, we've got a Firepower TV exclusive. We've managed to walk off with a prototype, and once they see this show, I'll be out of the country. What we've got right here is the SIG 226 X5. Now, tell us a little bit about this, Wes.
Well, this particular one here is one of the prototypes that they were working on. They sent it down here to let us look at it. This one here is going to be set up for a lot of competition shooters or a guy that wants to at least start into competition shooting. It's got a 5-inch barrel. It's a 226 stainless, but like I said, it's got a 5-inch barrel, but it's single action. It's not double action. It's got an ambidextrous safety, oversized slide release, and magazine release. Has the nil grips, a mag well. This gun is completely handmade and fitted. So this gun should be out of the box very accurate. It's got front slide serrations. I mean, the gun's set up for competition out of the box.
And if I wanted to be at the top of the mountain, mm-hmm, as a competition shooter, and I wanted the top of the mountain gun,
this would be it.
The gun will get you, the gun's capable of getting you there. You got to do the rest.
So if you got to ask how much it is, you don't need to because you don't need it.
Well, and it is also stainless, so it's not going to have a whole lot of recoil. And there's going to do this one, this particular one here is in 40.
Now, you know, in my small pea sized brain, the first thing I start thinking about is what type of tactical applications, because if it ain't tactical, it ain't practical. What can we do with this?
Well, the tactical light rail for flashlights or lasers, this would fit real well into law enforcement, you know, for close entry, no recoil, double taps, things like that. But I'm sure SIG has already probably thought of that.
I wonder.
More you to never come know. On
that. Well, I tell you what, I can't wait to shoot this, but before we get down there, check these out. We managed to swipe some knives too that SIG's
Yeah, SIG's actually coming out with a knife line, and this one here, it looks exactly like their grips on their firearms.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like it, the grip screws down to the bone, looks just like a SIG grip.
I mean, it is weighted perfect.
Yeah, it's half, on this particular one here, it's half serrated, half straight edge. It's got the Tanto style blade.
Mm-hmm.
That's a nice knife, well balanced too.
Oh, Tanto style.
Yeah, Tanto.
That is excellent. Now, I tell you what, they've also got an auto.
Yep, they're doing an auto for law enforcement and for the states to allow you to have a little auto there. They also are doing a neck knife, and the neck knife comes in handy for like a lot of officers. They can put it behind their body armor. Yeah, do things like that, special operations. It's just a backup, so nice little thing to have on you. Or to do that pose.
Okay, yeah, that's true. I like that's right, the pose, that's good. Okay, I tell you what, let's get down. Let's shoot these. Let's put these through the paces.
All right.
And I've got yet another Firepower TV extreme torture test for the certified pre-owned Sig Sauer pistols they sent us.
I don't know
if they're going to make it through this one.
They may not. Let's try it.
Let's go for it! All right, we're down here on the Firepower TV range. We've got the GSRs from Sig. That stands for Granite Series Rail. I've got the stainless. Wes has the Nitron finish. Let's go for the metal poppers.
All right.
Both at 45. Nice. Those are real nice.
Yeah.
These things are bad. All right, check this out. This is a Firepower TV exclusive. Wes has in his hands the 226 X5 40 caliber prototype made for Ipsen. Check this sucker out. Let's go for it. Prototype. That sucker's bad.
Very nice.
I refuse to give up on destroying the 226, so I brought out this metal monster weighing in at approximately 70,000 pounds. That's over 30 tons when it's sitting on top of you. I had the operator pull forward under our 226s one by one, roaring forward, surely to pummel the alloy and steel of the weapon into the rough, dry earth. After the dust cleared, the weapon still held to their to hell and back durability. But my idea of hell on Firepower TV and SIG's idea of hell are two very different things. Enter stage left, the industrial jackhammer mounted on the cat's massive hydraulic arm. I gave the operator of the crawler the order to push the pistol into the near concrete-like ground all the way to China. Once the jackhammer's bit made contact with the 226's alloy frame, you could hear the strain and moan of the hydraulics begin to cry out. Or was it the SIG finally crying out for mercy under this undaunting torture test that only the twisted minds of the gun guys at Firepower TV could muster? Over the drudge of the diesel engines, I began to yank and pull at the slide, which gave into my manhandle. I pulled the single action trigger and the hammer fell into position. I pulled the trigger in double action as well. Passed, but I had gotten the guns a little dirty, so we stopped by the automatic car wash to clean them off, Firepower TV style. But will they still shoot? I guess we'll have to see.
Firepower TV with the Gun Guys is brought to you by Sig Arms Precision Made Firearms, and by the FirePowerTV.us World Web Store, your destination for firearms, ammunition, and accessories.
FirePowerTV.us is the premier target destination on the web for shooting enthusiasts. FirePowerTV.us has the latest and greatest info on the gun guys and the Firepower TV show, as well as great deals on gear and ammo at the Firepower World Web Store. Set your sights on FirePowerTV.us for great deals and join the heavy metal Firepower movement.
Now let's get back to the two guys who couldn't shoot a barn if they were standing inside one, Chip and Wes the Gun Guys.
All right, it all comes down to this. Wes has in his hand a SIG 226 that we've put through some extreme torture. We've dropped it out of a helicopter to 150 feet on the pavement. We ran over with a 6x6 army truck. We drug it behind that truck with a metal cable on pavement and gravel. We ran over it with a bulldozer, and we used an industrial jackhammer to drive it into the ground. Will it shoot? That's the question. Are you ready? Good luck. I'd say that's a true testament to SIG's claim of the hell and back reliability. It passes the test.
All right, here's what we're gonna do.
Don't forget the fuel.
We're gonna go ahead, we're gonna try to have this car roll by. We're going to use the 552 Commando and a couple of our factory pre-certified SIGs that we put through torture tests to show they still work under harsh conditions. Try to stop this car. Getting it all together right now, so we don't know really how it's going to turn out, but we're going to go for it. We'll see if the SIG can stop this car from running roadblock. All right?
Yeah.
Done for, boys. You got a mag, Wes?
Yeah.
I'm not out yet. Hold that. Let's finish it off with our factory pre-certified pistol. The hell and back reliability. Nobody runs a roadblock on SIG.
I tell you what, that's all for today's show. We had a great time with those SIG sidearms. Now, if you want any information on our show, you can go to the World Wide Web, firepowertv.us. It's all the info you need. You ready to get out of here, big boy?
Let's do it.
Yeah, I think he's getting a little hungry. White Castle, we're on our way. We'll see you later.
He's not gonna make it back from this one.
Oh,
he is. Hang on. He's gotta make himself taller because he's too short. Kick the gravel up.
Okay, there you go. That's better.
That's what he has to do.
Yeah, can you make me a little stool?
A troll stool?
Let's see, let's get the number.
You think the works? You want to do a super wash? It's kind of dirty. Okay, let's do a super wash.